Yes. Now coming to chemical properties of alcohols. Look at the first reaction. Alcohols react with metallic sodium to liberate hydrogen. This is characteristic of compounds which show reasonably good acid strength. Okay? Yeah. So compounds which react with metal and liberate hydrogen are supposed to show acid character. So alcohols also show acid character. And what is the order of acid strength of alcohols? It's primary greater than secondary greater than tertiary. A primary alcohol is found to be more acidic than secondary alcohol, which in turn found to be more acidic than tertiary alcohol. So this is an important point related to acid strength of alcohols. Primary greater than secondary greater than tertiary. Then one more very important reaction of alcohols is that it can react with carboxylic acids. Alcohols react with carboxylic acids. In presence of sulfuric acid as a catalyst to give esters. This reaction is called esterification. That's a very prominent reaction of alcohols. See, in esterification, you have a carboxylic acid interacting with alcohol and a molecule of water is lost. That's what comes out. That's what is removed. And this reaction is catalyzed by a strong acid like sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid. Now here, sulfuric acid has a dual role to play. Yerad thara use agate sulfuric acid. Vandu, it works as a catalyst. Yerad ne do, it also acts like a dehydrating agent. Because water is the byproduct here. Okay? And notice one more thing, dear students. During esterification, it's the OH bond of alcohol that is cleaved. Okay? I'll write it here. In alcohol, OH bond is cleaved. Check this. OH bond is cleaved. Okay? In carboxylic acid, it's the CO bond that is cleaved. It's the CO bond that is cleaved. Then pit koli. In esterification, in alcohols, OH bond is cleaved. In carboxylic acids, CO bond is cleaved. Okay? Then order of reactivity of alcohols is primary greater than secondary greater than tertiary again during esterification. Note down this order as well. Note down this order. Okay, next. Now, alcohols also show a set of reactions where COH bond is broken. COH bond is cleaved. Okay? And look at the first set of reactions. Conversion of alcohols to alkyl halides. This is something we have discussed in haloalkanes chapter. Repetition ido. Alcohols made to react with HCl to give you chloroalkane. HBr gives you bromoalkane. Refluxing it with HI gives you iodoalkane. So we have seen this. Similarly, alcohols can be converted to haloalkanes using phosphorus halides. PCl5, PCl3, PBr3, PI3. All these reagents converts alcohol to corresponding haloalkane. We have already discussed this under haloalkanes worksheet. Next. There was one more. ROH with thionyl chloride. This is called Darzan's procedure. Please recollect this from haloalkanes worksheet. Darzan's procedure. Okay? Yes. All this we have discussed already. Then, alcohols can undergo dehydration. Dehydration, that is removal of water. This also was discussed under alkenes. While we were discussing methods of preparation of alkenes, we have discussed dehydration. Okay? So, dehydration involves removal of an OH group along with a beta hydrogen. This results in the formation of a double bond, an alkene, as the product of this elimination or dehydration minus water. Water gets removed. Right? Now, what is important here? Order of reactivity or ease of dehydration. Which alcohol undergoes dehydration easily? It is tertiary alcohol. Tertiary alcohols dehydrate readily when compared to secondary, followed by primary. Primary alcohol is the most difficult to be dehydrated. whereas tertiary alcohols are dehydrated very easily. And neevella ee mechanism na kalthukondirthira board exam ge. Dehydration of alcohols, mechanism of dehydration of alcohols. Step 1 involves protonation of alcohol. Step 2 involves formation of a carbocation as intermediate. Step 3 involves loss of proton and formation of alkene. So go through this mechanism once again, important. Step 1, step 2, step 3, dehydration of alcohols. Okay, then we have oxidation of alcohols. Remember, alcohols can be oxidized, right? Let us see what are the products of oxidation. One thing, the products of oxidation of alcohols depends on what type of oxidizing agent you are using, whether you are using a strong oxidizing agent or a mild oxidizing agent, okay, and what type of alcohol you are oxidizing, whether you are oxidizing a primary alcohol, secondary alcohol or a tertiary alcohol. Okay, now first let us take up oxidation of primary alcohols. Please check it. If you oxidize a primary alcohol using a strong oxidizing agent, acidified potassium dichromate, strong oxidizing agent or strong oxidant, then it converts ethanol to aldehyde, but that aldehyde is further oxidized to carboxylic acid. So a primary alcohol upon oxidation with a strong oxidizing agent will ultimately give you carboxylic acid. Okay, but using a very special reagent, you can stop the oxidation of a primary alcohol. This is a primary alcohol, ilnodi. A primary alcohol can be oxidized and the oxidation can be stopped at the aldehyde stage without getting further oxidized to carboxylic acid by using a special reagent. All of you can recollect this. You have studied this for the board exam again. PCC. What does PCC stand for? Pyridinium chlorochromate. Remember this, very important. Can be asked in the entrance exam. So if you use PCC, you can stop the oxidation at the aldehyde stage. Aldehyde will not get further converted to carboxylic acid. Okay, so that's about oxidation of primary alcohols. Now look at secondary alcohols. Primary alcohols usually give carboxylic acids upon oxidation, whereas secondary alcohols give us ketone. And ketone is not that easily oxidized further. Ketone oxidation is difficult. Therefore, secondary alcohols get oxidized to ketones. You should note it down. Important. Now come to tertiary alcohols. Tertiary alcohols is a special case. Tertiary alcohols are not prone to oxidation. Tertiary alcohols easily oxidize agalla, but under strong reaction conditions. Strong reaction conditions and reno, strong oxidizing agent, high temperature. Under these conditions, many bonds are cleaved. Many bonds are cleaved and you get fragmented products. You get fragmented products, carboxylic acids with less carbon atoms. Carboxylic acids with lesser carbon atoms. Yes, that is the fate of tertiary alcohols. That's what happens to tertiary alcohols. Okay, fine. Let's proceed further. This is about oxidation of alcohols. I'll quickly summarize this. Primary alcohols with strong oxidizing agent gives you carboxylic acids. Primary alcohols with a reagent like PCC or chromium trioxide gives you aldehyde. Secondary alcohols and oxidation gives you ketones. Tertiary alcohols upon oxidation under drastic conditions only gives you carboxylic acids with lesser number of carbon atoms. Okay. Next. Yes, you can also subject alcohols to dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation is simply removal of hydrogen. Removal of hydrogen. And that is done by using copper. Copper metal can adsorb hydrogen. So when you pass vapors of alcohol over heated copper metal, you have the following changes taking place. See, a primary alcohol upon dehydrogenation gives you an aldehyde. Always. Primary alcohol, aldehyde. Secondary alcohol upon dehydrogenation, secondary alcohol should give you a ketone. Whereas a tertiary alcohol will not undergo dehydrogenation. In fact, it will undergo dehydration. Because now we know that tertiary alcohols easily undergo dehydration. Most readily they undergo dehydration. Hence you get an alkene instead of any other compound. You get an elimination product, alkene. Yes, these are all the chemical properties of alcohols. Now let us focus on questions. Questions on this. Okay, question number 10. 23 milligrams of sodium metal is placed in excess of alcohol. Which alcohol can produce more amount of hydrogen gas? So here you have an alcohol made to react with metallic sodium. See what the products are? You get sodium alkoxide. Sodium alkoxide plus liberation of hydrogen gas. Now, if I have to balance this reaction, it would be 2 moles of alcohol giving you 2 moles of alkoxide utilizing 2 moles of sodium. Right? Now you are asked, between methanol, ethanol and propanol, which gives more amount of hydrogen gas? Please observe, whatever the nature of R group is, R group ene agirabodu, let the R group be methyl, ethyl, propyl, whatever, it always gives the same amount of hydrogen. Same amount. Because R, whatever R group is there in the alcohol, the same R group comes in alkoxide also. Right? So whether you take methanol, ethanol or propyl alcohol or for that matter any other alcohol, as long as it is monohydric, all monohydric alcohols, all monohydric alcohols liberate same amount of hydrogen. Same amount of hydrogen, irrespective of their R group. Okay? So the correct answer here is option 4, same amount. Fine. Next, question number 11. Which of the following has maximum pKa value? Okay, what is this pKa value? pKa scale is a measure of acid strength. Okay, note this important point. Lower the pKa value, stronger the acid. Okay? And what's the order of acid strength of alcohols? Order of acidity? Order of acidity is primary alcohol more acidic than secondary alcohol, more acidic than tertiary alcohol. Simple. Okay? So, ill kelirodenu, you have to find out which alcohol has maximum pKa. Maximum pKa value means, maximum pKa value suggests that the acid must be weak. Weak acid. Right? Among the three types of alcohols, primary, secondary and tertiary, which is the weakest? Tertiary alcohol, weak acid. Now, in this set of options, which is a tertiary alcohol? Option A. Observe Madi, it's a primary alcohol. Option B is also a primary alcohol. And I'm sure all of you can easily identify primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols because you just have to focus on the carbon to which OH is attached. Okay, if OH is attached to CH2 group, then it's primary alcohol. If it's attached to CH, ilnodi, option C nodi, this carbon atom is a CH carbon. This is secondary alcohol. And check out option D. The carbon atom to which OH is attached is in turn attached to three alkyl groups. Andre, this is a tertiary alcohol. This is a tertiary alcohol. So, we have to find out the compound with maximum pKa. That therefore must be a weak acid. Which is weak acid? Tertiary alcohol is weak acid. Which is a tertiary alcohol example here? It's option D. So, option D becomes our correct answer. Just an additional point. pKa is related to Ka by this relationship. pKa is equal to negative log of acid dissociation constant Ka. Okay? Yes. This is the information for this question. Question number 11. Okay. Hope you have taken it down, all of you. Now, let me move on to the next question. Question number 12. Examine the following reaction. First of all, try to identify what reaction is it. Here we have a carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid. And here you have alcohol. And this is acid catalyst. So whenever carboxylic acid reacts with an alcohol in presence of acid, what's the product we expect? We get an ester. And hence, what reaction is this? This is esterification reaction. Esterification reaction. Very good. So now, this is an interesting question. Illi oxygen atom mele eno ond asterisk mark ide yenadu? We'll check it out. That is indicated as it's an isotope of oxygen. See, what's the normal oxygen isotope? O16. In addition to O16, oxygen exists in other isotopic forms. O18 is one of them, right? So yen madidare andre in the alcohol, the oxygen atom that is taken is the O18 oxygen. You call it the labeled oxygen. This experiment is called labeling experiment. Carboxylic acid has normal O16 oxygens, whereas alcohol here has O18 oxygen. Okay. Now, what you are supposed to find out is, after the reaction, where has this labeled oxygen gone? Okay. Is it in water? The water, Lydia? Or is it in the ester formed? Or has it vanished? It's not there at all. We'll check it out. We'll check it out. Okay. Now, for the answer in this question, you should know which are the bonds that are broken in carboxylic acid and alcohol during esterification. Okay. If you know which bonds are broken during esterification, you can easily answer this question. That is something we discussed in the synopsis as well. I am showing it again. See, RCOOH, this is your carboxylic acid, made to react with alcohol, ROH. Now, the oxygen of alcohol is the labeled oxygen, O18, right? And see what happens during esterification. During esterification, as I've told you, in the alcohol, it is the OH bond that is broken. In the alcohol, it is the OH bond that is broken. Whereas in carboxylic acid, it is the CO bond that is broken. And this would be removed as water. Okay? So if water comes out, observe Madi. Does water, oxygen of water, carry any O18 or labeled oxygen? No. Where is the labeled oxygen now? Labeled oxygen is now part of the ester. See, RCO, this is joined by OR, this is coming from alcohol, therefore this is labeled oxygen, O18, plus water. Water alli labeled oxygen irodilla. Okay? Now, see in which option you have asterisk mark, which option you have asterisk marked oxygen in the ester. Let's find out which option has the labeled oxygen in the ester. That is option B. See, in the esterification reaction, we got to know that CO bond of carboxylic acid is broken, OH bond of alcohol is broken, which means the labeled oxygen, this labeled oxygen that goes in the ester, that goes with ester, not with water. Hence, option B is correct. Mark this as a very, very important question. Very important question. That is question number 12 for you. Okay? Yes. Hope you all have written it down along with me. Okay. We'll proceed further now. Question number 13. There is a reaction given here. Again, reactions or questions based on sequence of reactions. ಈ ತರ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಹ್ಯಾಲೋ ಆಲ್ಕೇನ್ಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ನೋಡಿದ್ವಿ. ವಿ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯೂ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ರೈಟ್? ಅ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್. ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಈಚ್ ಆಫ್ ದೋಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಟು ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ವೈ ಇರಬೇಕು, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿಸ್ಡ್ ಔಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೋ ವೈ ಈಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್? ವೈ ಈಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೈ ಆರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ take up the solution for this. So you have ethanol, C2H5OH, ethanol. Ethanol is made to react with acidified potassium permanganate. Remember, potassium permanganate is a very powerful oxidizing agent. Ethanol is a primary alcohol. Ethanol is a primary alcohol. So we know a primary alcohol upon oxidation by a strong oxidizing agent should give you carboxylic acid. Now, what is the carboxylic acid formed? Remember, the carboxylic acid formed must have the same number of carbon atoms as alcohol. Alcohol, less carbon atoms are there? 2. It is ethanol. It is ethanol. Which means the carboxylic acid also should have 2 carbon atoms. It is ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid. So, we now know what our compound X is. X is ethanoic acid. So, check maadi, in which option you have X as ethanoic acid? Option 1, it is given as methanol, wrong. Option 2, it's given as ethanol, aldehyde, wrong. Option 3, it's given as ethene, wrong. Option 4, you see you have acetic acid. Yes, straight away you can identify the answer is option 4. Okay, just by finding out X, you are able to find out the correct answer. Now, we know why kandidde illa. We don't know what Y is, but still we are able to arrive at the correct answer. This is what is elimination of options. Okay, the moment you get a clue, one the clue sikkut takshana, try to eliminate the other options. That's when you'll figure out what the correct option is. Okay, see, as you can notice, we have not found out what Y is, but just out of curiosity, let's see what Y is. Okay, so X is a carboxylic acid that is made to react with Y. Made to react with Y in presence of an acid. Okay, so what must be Y? So if a carboxylic acid has to be reacted with any other compound in presence of an acid, that has to be an alcohol. That has to be an alcohol. Okay, and in the given option it is ethyl alcohol. So it matches. It matches with our analysis. Yes? Okay. And therefore, the product will be an ester. The product will be an ester. Yes. Option 4 is the answer for this. Question number 13. Okay. We'll go to question number 14 now. Question number 14, I think, is on phenols. Okay. That's about all the questions from alcohols. We have discussed around 14 questions on alcohols, all sample questions. Now we'll come to phenols. You all know phenols are characterized by the presence of OH group directly attached to benzene ring. That's what phenols are. Phenol itself is adopted IUPAC name. It's an accepted IUPAC name, phenol. And phenol is also known as carbolic acid. Just one additional information. Please note that. Okay. And naming system is same. Carbon having OH group should get the first priority. That's numbered one. Then the carbon having substituent is numbered two. This will be one. This will be three. This will be one. This will be four. Okay. So that's how phenols are named. Right. Then just like how you classify alcohols as monohydric, dihydric and trihydric, phenols can also be classified as monohydric, dihydric and trihydric. Okay. Next. Okay, now coming to methods of preparation. Methods of preparation of phenols. There are 4 methods of preparation given in your syllabus. Just focus on those 4 methods. First one, by warming diazonium salt. This is diazonium chloride. Please recollect, in our last worksheet, we have come across this compound, diazonium salt, in Sandmeyer's reaction. Nenpuskoli? Okay, so the same diazonium salt solution, upon slight warming in presence of an acid, you get phenol. Okay. Then we have this very important method called the Dow's process, where chlorobenzene is made to react with sodium hydroxide under high temperature, high pressure. You first get sodium phenoxide, which upon acidification gives you phenol. Then you can also prepare phenol from benzene sulfonic acid. How? Fuse it with hydroxide. For sodium hydroxide, jothe fuse madidre, you'll get sodium phenoxide. And once you get sodium phenoxide, you can convert it into phenol by acidification, right? But of all the 4 methods, the most important method is this cumene process. very very important method, cumene process. Okay, cumene is isopropyl benzene. Cumene is the common name for isopropyl benzene. Isopropyl group attached to benzene. Now that upon oxidation by using oxygen in air, you get cumene hydroperoxide, which upon hydrolysis undergoes rearrangement to give you two valuable products. You not only get phenol, you also get acetone. One day reaction alli erdu important products barutte. That's why it's a very important method, phenol and acetone. So cumene process, please concentrate, you can get questions on that. Okay, next. Yes, we now have questions on phenols. Question number 14. 1, 2, 3 trihydroxybenzene. 1, 2, 3 trihydroxybenzene. I'll write the structure. Benzene. Okay. 1, 2, 3 means OH groups, hydroxy groups are OH groups here. OH groups are on adjacent carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3. Okay. What is the name of this compound? This compound is pyrogallol. So you should check out all the examples given in your NCERT textbook. NCERT textbook alli monohydric, trihydric and dihydric phenols examples ide. Okay, under that you get it. Pyrogallol is a trihydric phenol. Fluoroglucinol is also trihydric. Resorcinol is a dihydric phenol. Quinol is also a dihydric phenol. Okay, so please practice their structures and remember their names. You can get simple questions like this. Question number 15, Barana. The reaction used to prepare phenol industrially, the reaction used to prepare phenol industrially is, option A is Dow's process. Option A is Dow's process. That's an industrial process. That's an industrial process. Option B is fusion of alkali fusion of sodium benzene sulfonate, alkali fusion. That's also an industrial method. In fact, this was one of the oldest methods of preparation of phenol. Okay. Option C, recognize Madi. Let me see. Please recognize option C. I'm sure all of you would have recognized it by now. It is cumene process, which also is an industrial process. Cumene process. 80% of phenol production happens by option C, cumene process. 80% of total world's phenol production happens by cumene process. Okay, therefore all options here are industrial processes, hence all of these is the correct answer. All of these is the correct answer. Okay, that was an easy question. Now moving on further, question number 16. Consider the following sequence of reactions. You have to identify what products B and C are. Easy. This is benzene and this is propene. In presence of H3PO4, what you get is cumene. I'll show this. You have benzene. Made to react with propene. CH3CH, double bond CH2. In presence of phosphoric acid, H3PO4. Okay, so this results in the formation of isopropyl benzene, which is nothing but cumene. CH3, cumene. Now, what is done to cumene compound A? First, it is air oxidized, air oxygen, oxidation, followed by hydrolysis. So, you know, upon air oxidation, you get cumene hydroperoxide. This is what you get, CH3 as it is, and then you have two oxygen atoms here inserted. This is cumene hydroperoxide. This upon hydrolysis, you know, gives two valuable products, your cumene process. What are the two valuable products? Phenol and acetone. Phenol baratte, and in addition to it, you also get acetone. CH3CO CH3. Yes, so what is the correct option? You should get phenol. Which options have phenol? option C and option D. But in option D, you have phenol along with propanone. Propanone is acetone. So option D is the correct option. Yes. Next. Next question. This is cumin process. You can also find it in NCERT textbook. Sadhyavadashtu Bega Barkoli. I'll just wait for a couple of seconds. Okay, done. Next. Propanone is acetone. So option D is the correct option. Yes. Next. Next question. This is cumin process. You can also find it in NCERT textbook. Sadhyavadashtu Bega Barkoli. I'll just wait for a couple of seconds. Okay, done. Next. Coming to physical properties of phenols. Now, like alcohols, phenols also show intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Therefore, phenols also have higher boiling point than corresponding aromatic hydrocarbons. But unlike alcohols, phenols are not that easily soluble in water. Phenols are sparingly soluble in water. Okay, solubility is lower than that of alcohols. That's because of benzene ring, hydrocarbon part. Benzene ring is hydrophobic. This is the hydrophobic part. Hydrophobic. Okay. Yes, that's about physical properties. Next. Okay, there is a question on physical property. The correct order of increasing boiling point. Increasing order nodbeko. Between phenol, orthonitrophenol, paranitrophenol. This is phenol. OH. Okay. Then we have orthonitrophenol. One second. I'll explain the structure. Orthonitrophenol. Okay. And then you have paranitrophenol. OH and NO2. Now, how do we decide the boiling point? Remember the first point. Higher the molar mass, higher the boiling point. So, both orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol will obviously have a higher boiling point than phenol. Phenol must be the lowest. Phenol must be the lowest. So, find out in which option phenol is lowest. Option C and phenol lowest there, and even in option A. So, the correct answer must be between A and C. Then, we have to decide between orthonitrophenol. Orthonitrophenol. And paranitrophenol. Okay. So, how do we decide between these two? Please note, all the three compounds here, phenol, orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol shows intermolecular hydrogen bonding. But here, there is something interesting with respect to orthonitrophenol. Observe this. In case of orthonitrophenol, there is intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding within the same molecule. Intramolecular. Intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding within the same molecule. Okay? So, because of intramolecular hydrogen bonding, it can't associate well with other molecules, and therefore boiling point of orthonitrophenol will be less than paranitrophenol, which shows intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Here it is inter. Inter means between molecules. Intra is within the same molecule. Intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Yes, so that's the order. So paranitrophenol with the highest boiling point compared to orthonitro, then phenol. So which option? Phenol less than orthonitrophenol less than paranitrophenol. Option A. Option A is the correct answer. Yes. Now, next question. Or I think next we have chemical properties of phenols. We'll check that out. Yes. We have chemical properties of phenols. Phenols, like alcohols, also liberate hydrogen gas with metals, which means phenols also show acid character, acidity of phenols. And it is found that acid strength of phenols are greater than that of alcohols. Phenols are stronger acids than alcohols. Important point. Please note, phenols stronger acids than alcohols. Okay, which means phenols will have a lower pKa value than alcohols, right? Okay. Then, how will substituents present influence acid strength of phenols? How will substituents influence the acid strength of phenols? You have two types of substituents usually attached to benzene ring. They are the electron withdrawing groups, okay, and the electron releasing groups. This is universal. Please stick to this, okay? Whatever may be the organic compound you're dealing with, electron withdrawing groups always increase acid strength. Not just the phenols. Next, we'll go to carboxylic acids. Even there, it's the same story. Electron withdrawing groups increase acid strength generally, okay? Generally. Of course, there are exceptions. Electron releasing groups decrease acid strength. That's a general trend, okay? Which are the electron withdrawing groups? Nitro group, halogens, carboxylic acids, all your minus R groups. All your minus R groups and halogens. Though chlorine is plus R, it's still deactivating. It's electron withdrawing. Then all your plus R groups and alkyl groups are electron releasing. Okay? So, it's an important point. Then bitkovic. Right. And why phenols are stronger acids than alcohols? Simple reason. Phenoxide ion is resonance stabilized. This is phenoxide ion. And stabilized by resonance. Resonance. Okay? Yeah. Now, in one slide, I have covered all reactions of phenols, important reactions of phenols. Let me just give you an overview of this. Okay? Phenol subjected to nitration, nitrating mixture, strong nitrating mixture gives you 2,4,6 trinitrophenol, which is picric acid. But same phenol with dilute nitric acid, see here, dilute nitric acid gives you a mixture of orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol. Of course, they differ a lot in their boiling point, hence they can be separated by distillation, steam distillation. Okay. Next, phenol with bromine in a non-polar solvent. Bromine in a non-polar solvent, it gives a mixture of ortho and para product. Ortho product, minor product always, para product is major. But same phenol with bromine water, bromine in a polar solvent gives you 2,4,6 tri-bromophenol, a white precipitate. That's the difference. Okay. And then phenol upon reaction with sodium hydroxide. One second. Yeah. Phenol upon reaction with sodium hydroxide gives sodium phenate, which upon further reaction with carbon dioxide followed by hydrolysis gives you salicylic acid. This is a very important name reaction called Kolbe reaction. And one more important name reaction under phenols is Reimer-Tiemann reaction. Reimer-Tiemann reaction. All of you would have studied this for your board exam. So, for Reimer-Tiemann reaction, phenol is treated with chloroform in presence of a base. That's when you get salicylaldehyde. So, remember these two points. In Kolbe reaction, you get salicylic acid. In Reimer-Tiemann reaction, you get salicylaldehyde. Salicylaldehyde. Okay. Apart from it, you have other reactions like Friedel-Crafts alkylation and Friedel-Crafts acylation. Okay. And phenols also react with neutral FeCl3. That's one characteristic reaction of phenol. Using neutral FeCl3, you can actually detect phenol. And upon oxidation, with a strong oxidizing agent like dichromate, phenol gives a colored compound, benzoquinone. A wine red colored compound, benzoquinone. Okay. So, these are reactions of phenols overall. Okay. Right. In one page, you get a glance of all the reactions of phenols. Next, we'll go to questions. Yes. We have a couple of questions on phenols. We'll try to complete as much as possible. In the following compounds, there is phenol, there is nitrophenol, 4-methylphenol and 4-nitrophenol. what is the order of acidity. We have to find out order of acidity. Okay, we'll write the structures of all these now. I'll write phenol first. Yes, this is phenol. OH. Then compound 2, this is compound 1. Compound 2 is 4-methyl phenol. It's cresol. Common name is cresol. Paracresol. OH. And methyl group here. 4-methyl. Compound number 2. Compound 3 is 3-nitrophenol. How do we write the structure of 3-nitrophenol? You know, carbon carrying OH is numbered 1. Then at the third carbon you have nitro group. This is also called metanitrophenol. 3-nitrophenol. This is compound 3. Then you have compound 4, which is 4-nitrophenol or paranitrophenol. OH. Nitro. Compound 4. Paranitrophenol. Yes. So, among these compounds 1, 2, 3, 4, we have to find out what is the order of acid strength. Remember important points. Electron withdrawing groups increase acid strength. That's what we discussed, correct? Electron releasing groups decrease acid strength. Now, which are the electron withdrawing groups here? Nitro is electron withdrawing group. This also is nitro group, electron withdrawing. Electron releasing, CH3 is electron releasing group, ERG. Okay. Of course, phenol has neither an electron withdrawing group nor an electron releasing group. Okay. Now, electron releasing group decrease acid strength. Which is electron releasing here? Methyl. So, that must be the weakest of acids among all compounds. 4-methyl phenol, compound number 2, must be the weakest. Okay. See in which option you have two at the end, two lowest. Option 1 only there, option 2 and option 3 have two the lowest. Okay. Then comes phenol, because phenol has neither electron withdrawing group nor releasing group. So after 2, you should have 1. After 2, you should have 1. In which option? In option 1, you have it. 1 greater than 2. In option 4 also you have it, 1 greater than 2. So our answer must be between option 1 and option 4. Check marna. Then we have decided 2 and 1. Now between 3 and 4, metanitrophenol and paranitrophenol. Remember, at the para position, nitro group can strongly withdraw electrons by resonance. NO2 strong electron withdrawing group at para position due to resonance effect. At para position, on account of resonance phenomenon. The resonance phenomenon is not prominent at the meta position. So if nitro group strongly withdraws electrons at the para position, then that must be the strongest acid, which means 4 must be the strongest. In which option you have 4 strongest? Option 4. So it is compound 4, paranitrophenol, followed by compound 3, metanitrophenol, followed by phenol. Then at the end you have 4-methyl phenol. That's the order of acid strength. Mark it as an important question. It's a very important question. Option 4 is the answer. Yes, good. That was question number 18. We are almost coming to the end of the session. Let me see if I can squeeze in one more question here. Hope all of you have copied this down. This is important. Okay, next. Yeah, I think these questions are easy. We can complete it. When phenol is treated with excess bromine water, water is a polar solvent. So, we discussed it in the synopsis slides. When phenol is made to react with bromine water, bromine in a polar solvent like water, you get substitution at all the three active positions. Which are the three active positions for a phenol? It is the two ortho positions and the lonely para position. Okay, so two ortho positions and the lone para position. So you get 2, 4, 6 tribromophenol, option 4. 2, 4, 6 tribromophenol, option 4. Okay. 2, 4, 6 tribromophenol, option 4. Okay. Next, 20th question. I think with this we'll make it the last question for the day. Phenol on treatment with concentrated HNO3. Concentrated HNO3. Okay, so we know with concentrated HNO3, what's the outcome? Phenol OH made to react with concentrated HNO3. Again, because you are treating it with a strong nitrating mixture, you would get substitution at all the three active positions, which is 2, 4, 6, the two ortho positions and the lone para position. OH, NO2 and NO2. This is picric acid. This is commonly called picric acid. So option A is the answer. Option 1 is the answer. So this is about question number 20. Okay, let's see what question number 21 is. Or if it is ethers, then we will stop. Okay, we have a couple of questions. It's okay. Let us take it up for our next class. So thank you, dear students. So this is about alcohols and phenols. We have a few questions remaining on phenols. Next class, we will complete these remaining questions on phenols. Then take up ethers. Ethers will not take much time. Probably I can also start the next topic in my next class. And the next topic will be aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acids. I repeat, next worksheet, next topic will be aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acids. Thank you.